Welcome to this video on the NCDOT migration from SharePoint 2010 to SharePoint 2013. The migration to SharePoint 2013 will affect your work with the NCDOT websites, so this video focuses on the changes between the two versions of SharePoint to help you get up to speed quickly. In SharePoint 2013, the Site Actions menu is now called Settings and is represented by a gear icon. In SharePoint 2010, the Site Actions menu is located at the top left of Inside NCDOT. And on Connect NCDOT, the Site Actions menu is at the top right. Let's go to the SharePoint 2013 version of Inside. The Settings gear is in the top right, and it's located in the same place on Connect. As you hover over the gear icon, you'll see a tooltip that says Settings. Remember, the options you see depend upon your permissions. In SharePoint 2013, the View All Site Content command is now called Site Contents and has a very different look and feel. We'll use Inside NCDOT as our example. In SharePoint 2010, the Site Actions menu contained an option to view all site content. When you chose that option, the Site Content page was organized by libraries, lists, and subsites, and the recycle bin was at the bottom of the page. Let's move over to SharePoint 2013. Here, the View All Site Content command is called Site Contents and is now under the Settings gear. When you go to the Site Contents page, the display is quite different. Lists and libraries have Metro-style icons and are presented in alphabetical order. And the recycle bin has moved from the bottom of the page to the top right. In SharePoint 2013, you will now see the term Apps. We'll use Inside NCDOT as our example. In SharePoint 2010, here is an All Site Content page. Here's a Site Contents page in SharePoint 2013. The first section of the Site Contents page is lists, libraries, and other apps. So SharePoint 2013 now considers lists and libraries apps. You will also see this app terminology when you insert a web part in SharePoint 2013. Don't let this confuse you. You can continue to use the terms list and library as long as you understand that in some places SharePoint will call them apps. In SharePoint 2013, the ribbon has a cleaner, flatter look and feel. We'll use a library in Connect NCDOT as our example. Here's the 2010 ribbon that you're familiar with, and here's the 2013 ribbon. The ribbon and tabs are a bit more subdued. If you have been using Office 2013 applications, this will already look familiar. Let's go back to the 2010 library and look at the text on the tabs. Library Tools is the header for the Documents and Library tabs. And here's the text on the same ribbon in 2013. The tabs are simply labeled Files and Library. So a second change is that the text on the tabs has been simplified. In SharePoint 2013, it is much easier to find the Open menu. We'll use a list in Inside NCDOT as our example. In 2010, you had to hover over an item to display a down arrow, then click that arrow to get to the Open menu. In the 2013 version of this list, you see an ellipsis to indicate that a menu is available. If you hover over the ellipsis, you'll see a tooltip that says Open Menu. And if you click the ellipsis, you'll see the Open Menu options. In SharePoint 2013, List and Library Views are easier to see. We'll use an Inside NCDOT library as our example. In this 2010 library, the default view of all documents was automatically displayed. To determine if additional views were available, you had to click the down arrow in the breadcrumb. Let's look at the same library in 2013. Up to three views are listed at the top of a list, with the default view on the left. To see if there are more views available, click the ellipsis. In this video, we've taken a look at some of the important changes between SharePoint 2010 and 2013. We encourage you to check out our other videos and to contact the PC Training Group for information on SharePoint 2013 classes. Thanks for watching.